Hi, this is Asin. You are now watching Asin Math TV. Today, I would like to share the Maclaurin series of log 1 plus cos x. When we differentiate log 1 plus cos x to the base 10, we should obtain differentiate log is 1 plus cos x times the base ln 10, differentiate cos, we obtain negative sine x. Instead of applying product rule or quotient rule for this complicated function, we can actually split the fraction. So we can let the numerator be fx without taking the negative sign. So we have sine x, and for the function g be the denominator part 1 plus cos x without the constant ln 10. At point x equal to 0, sine 0 is equal to 0. And for the function g, g0 is equal to 1 plus cos 0, which is 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Differentiate for the first time, differentiate sine, we obtain cos. At point 0, we have 1. Differentiate g with respect to x, we obtain negative sine. At point 0, we have 0. Differentiate for the second time, differentiate cos is negative sine. At point 0, we have 0. As we can see, the derivative of the function g is actually the shift of the derivative of the function f. In other words, we have g m minus 1 or m minus 1 derivative of function g is equal to the n derivative of the function f. For n is equal to 2, 3, 4, and so on, which means that we can differentiate the function f only without differentiating both functions, and this can help us to save time. Now we should differentiate the function f. For the third time, differentiate sine is cos. At point 0, we have negative 1. Differentiate for the fourth time, differentiate cos is negative sine. Negative, negative, positive. At point 0, we have 0 again. Differentiate for the fifth time, we obtain cos. At point 0, we have 1, since we already obtained 1, 2, and 3 non-zero terms, and now we should be able to form the Maclaurin series for both the functions. For the function f, which is sine x, is equal to, this is the first derivative, we have 1 over 1 factorial x to the power of 1, plus the derivative, negative 1 over 3 factorial x to the power 3, fifth derivative plus 1 over 5 factorial x to the power 5, and so on. For the function g, we have original function 2, and we plus, starting from there, n equal to 2 of the function f, which means that starting from here, since this is 0, we can ignore with take the third derivative, but for the function g is n minus 1, so that become second, 2 factorial x to the power of 2, and fifth become 4, so we have 1 over 4 factorial x to the power of 4, and so on. Let's simplify, so we have 1 over 1, which is 1, x to the power of 1x, minus 1 over 6, x to the power of 3, plus 1 over 120 x to the power of 5, and so on. And for function g, we have 2 minus 1 over 2 x squared plus 1 over 24 x to the power of 4. Since we have obtained the Maclaurin series for the function f and g, and what we need here is sine x over 1 plus cos x, which means that we can apply long division to obtain this. We have x minus 1 over 6 x cubed plus 1 over 120 x to the power of 5, and so on, divided by 2 minus 1 over 2x squared plus 1 over 24x to the power 4 and so on. The rule of thumb of applying long division is always reduce the first term to 0. In order to obtain 0, we should minus x, which means that the first term that we should times is 1 over 2x. And for the second term, we should obtain negative 1 over 4x cubed, and the third term we should have 1 over 48 x to the power 5 and so on. Let's minus, we have negative 1 over 6. We minus negative 1 over 4 and we obtain positive 1 over 12x cubed. And for the third term we have 1 over 120 minus 1 over 48. And we obtain negative 1 over 80 x to the power 5 and so on. Again, we should reduce the first term to 0. So which means that we should times positive 1 over 24 x to the power of 3. So we obtain 1 over 12 x cubed. When we minus, we obtain 0. Negative, positive remain negative. And we should have 1 over 48 x to the power of 5 and so on. Again, we minus negative 1 over 80 minus negative 1 over 48 and we obtain 1 over 120 x to the power of 5 and so on, which means that the third term that we should have here is plus 1 over 240 x to the power of 5 and so on. Recall that when we differentiate log 1 plus cos x to the base 10, we should obtain negative 1 over ln 10 times sine x over 1 plus cos x, which is the series 1 over 2x plus 1 over 24x cubed plus 1 over 240x to the power 5 and so on. If we integrate both sides with respect to x, we should obtain integrate, differentiate, cancel each other. Differentiate x, cancel, differentiate x. We obtain log 1 plus cos x to the base 10 is equal to negative 1 over ln 10 times, when we integrate, we have power plus 1 over power plus 1 plus 1 over 24, again power plus 1 over power plus 1 plus 1 over 240 power plus 1 over power plus 1. And so on. Remember to add the constant c, and what should be the constant c depends on what we are expanding. Refer back to the function. C is equal to, at Maclaurin series, we know that x is equal to 0, which means that we have log 1 plus cos 0. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, so we have log 2. In other words, we have log 2 minus 1 over ln 10 times 1 over 4x squared plus 1 over 96x power 4 plus 1 over 1440x to the power 6 and so on. And we know that log 2 can be rewrite as ln 2 over ln 10, which means that we have 1 over ln 10 times ln 2 minus 1 over 4x squared minus 1 over 96x power 4 minus 1 over 1440x to the power of 6 and so on. And hence we done. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.